In fancy she looked forward to the coming years, and saw Camilla Jane growing up into girlhood, fair and lovable. "She'll be a beauty," reflected Miss Rosetta complacently. "Jane was a handsome girl. She shall always be dressed as nice as I can manage it. And I'll get her an organ, and have her take painting and music lessons. Parties, too. I'll give her a real coming-out party when she's 18, and the very prettiest dress that's to be had. Dear me, I can hardly wait for her to grow up, though she's sweet enough now to make one wish she could stay a baby forever." When Miss Rosetta returned to the kitchen, her eyes fell on an empty cradle. Camilla Jane was gone! Miss Rosetta promptly screamed. She understood at a glance what had happened. 6 months-old babies do not get out of their cradles and disappear through closed doorways without any assistance. "Charlotte has been here," gasped Miss Rosetta. "Charlotte has stolen Camilla Jane. I might have expected it. I might have known when I heard that story about her buying muslin and flannel. It's just like Charlotte to do such an underhand trick. But I'll go after her. I'll show her. She'll find out she has got Rosetta Ellis to deal with and no Wheeler." Like a frantic creature, and wholly forgetting that her hair was up in curl papers, Miss Rosetta hurried up the hill and down the shore road to the Wheeler farm, a place she had never visited in her life before. The wind was offshore and only broke the bay's surface into long silvery ripples, and sent sheeny shadows flying out across it from every point and headland like transparent wings. The little gray house, so close to the purring waves that in storms their spray splashed over its very doorstep, seemed deserted. Miss Rosetta pounded lustily on the front door. This producing no result, she marched around to the back door and knocked. No answer. Miss Rosetta tried the door. It was locked.